Hey Steam, welcome to Ace Academy. I'm Harini and today we will be looking at the most important current affairs of June 25, 2021. So without much delay, let's get into the first question. So the first question is, in India, which day is celebrated as the National Reading Day by CBSE? So the answer is option B, on 19th of June. So the Central Board of Secondary Education celebrates National Reading Day on 19th of June. Moving on to the next question. Second question is, global sports brand Puma India has extended partnership with which of the former Indian cricketer? So the answer is option A, Yuvraj Singh. So global sports brand Puma India has extended partnership with former Indian cricketer Yuvraj Singh, who has been associated with the brand for over a decade. Moving on to the next question. Third question is, Kenneth Kunda, who has passed away, was the former president of which country? So the answer is option D, Zambia. Zambian politician Kenneth Kunda, who served as the first president of Zambia, has passed away. Moving on to the next question. Fourth question is, which ministry has launched Aadi Prasiksha Portal? So the answer is option C, Ministry of Tribal Affairs. Ministry of Tribal Affairs has launched the Aadi Prasiksha Portal and a 3-day online training program on capacity building for the EST Panchayat Raj Institution members as part of Azadi Ka Amrut Mahotsav celebration. Moving on to the next question. Fifth question is, when is the International Day for the Elimination of Sexual Violence in Conflict commemorated? So the answer is option A, on 19th of June. So the International Day for the Elimination of Sexual Violence is commemorated on 19th of June. Moving on to the next question. Sixth question is, which former Indian sprinter has passed away? So the answer is option B, Milkha Singh, and he was 91 years old and the cause of death is COVID-19. After a month-long battle with the COVID-19 in Chandigarh, he passed away. Moving on to the next question. Seventh question is, India has signed the line of credit agreement with Sri Lanka in which sector? So the answer is option A, solar energy sector. India has extended a line of credit of $100 million to Sri Lanka through the Exim Bank for financing projects in the solar energy sector in Sri Lanka. Moving on to the next question. Eighth question is, who is the winner of the 2021 Land for Life Award given by the UN Conventions to Combat Desertification? So the answer is option A, Familia Forestry, Rajasthan, India. The 2021 Land for Life Award has been won by Familia Forestry of Rajasthan, a unique concept that relates a tree with a family, making it a green family member. Moving on to the next question. Ninth question is, which country has topped the Global Peace Index 2021? So the answer is option B, Iceland. Iceland has retained the top spot in the index as the most peaceful country since 2008. Moving on to the next question. Tenth question is, who has been appointed as director at the India's WTO mission? So the answer is option C, Ashish Chandrokar. So government has appointed a private person, Ashish Chandrokar, as counselor in the India's permanent mission in the World Trade Organization for 3 years. Moving on to the next question. 11th question is, LIC Card Services has launched a contactless prepaid gift card, Shagun, in collaboration with which bank? So the answer is option C, IDBI Bank. LIC Card Services has launched a contactless prepaid gift cards, Shagun, in collaboration with IDBI Bank on the RuPay platform. Moving on to the next question. Twelfth question is, the World Health Organization has recently identified a new variant of Lambda of COVID-19 in how many countries? So the answer is option C, 29 countries. WHO officials informed about a new variant named Lambda, which has been identified in 25 countries and is believed to have originated in South America. Moving on to the next question. Thirteenth question is, Democracy's Lemon headline was in recent news during the G7 summit. Which countries are part of the Democracy's Lemon along with G7 member countries? So the answer is option B, India, South Korea, Australia and South Africa. So India, South Korea, Australia and South Africa are part of Democracy's Lemon along with G7 member countries which are in news during the G7 summit. Moving on to the next question. 14th question is, which ministry has launched a national helpline number to report cyber crime? So the answer is option C, Ministry of Home Affairs. Ministry of Home Affairs has operationalized the national helpline 155260 and reporting platform for preventing financial loss due to cyber fraud. Moving on to the next question. Fifteenth question is, the Global Peace Index is released by which organization? So the answer is option B, Institute for Economics and Peace. So it is released by Institute for Economics and Peace. Moving on to the next question. Sixteenth question is, which East Asian country is facing a tense food shortage? So the answer is option A, North Korea. North Korea leader Kim Jong-un issued a rare warning about the tense food situation brought about by extensive flooding, the coronavirus pandemic and international sanctions. Moving on to the next question. Seventeenth question is, the World Sickle Cell Day is observed every year on which day? So the answer is option D, a 19th of June. It is celebrated to raise awareness about the sickle cell disease. Moving on to the next question. Eighteenth question is, which country has been banned from competing in weightlifting at the Tokyo Olympics over past doping crises? So the answer is option B, Romania. Romania, Switzerland has been banned from competing in weightlifting at the Tokyo Olympics over past doping cases, the International Weightlifting Federation ruled. Moving on to the next question. 19th question is, what is the rank of India in the Global Peace Index 2021? So the answer is option B, 135. India has moved up two places to rank 135 among 163 countries on the Global Peace Index 2021. So that's it. We are done for the day and thank you for watching our video. And if you think that we are doing good, please let us know in the comment section below. And if you have any doubts, please feel free to ask us either in the comment section below or you could also contact us on Facebook and Instagram. So I'll meet you in my next video. Till then, bye. It's me, Harini, signing off.